Alexi, you ride Golden Effort on Wednesday night at Happy Valley. He's having his first start. What sort of feel does this horse give you?
I think the horse is improving. He gave me a good feeling on the last trial. He broke very fast and he looks like a consistent horse. I hope he can do something like that Happy Valley night.
Does he give you the feeling he's a sort of horse that can handle a tight track like Happy Valley?
Yes, probably. He's very strong. It's a little horse, but he's very easy to ride. So I think he can do something good in Happy Valley.
And how fit does the horse feel for his first run?
He looks like fit enough. You know, he's very he's a bit keen. He's a kind of horse very he's a sprinter for sure. So he's a bit keen. He has a good heart. Maybe it's interesting to see.
Last week was good to see you get a double at Happy Valley. Nice for the winners to start to come.
Yeah, very, very good for me. It was brilliant, and Confucius Spirit gave me a first win, and I think he can make it a second time. I hope so. And it was very good to win a class two for Danishum.
Yeah, I felt he had improvement to come. Look, we drew an awkward gate and sort of had to press forward and did a bit of work in the early part of the race to sort of get outside the lead. And once he got there, he was able to sort of relax and sort of get a couple of soft sectionals. But that early work told late in the finish of the race, and he was still pretty yelling in running fourth. And I sort of felt, walking away from the last meeting that he could take good improvement from that, and especially from a good draw, be very competitive.
So now, from a good draw, where would you like to have him?
Well, I think he's got enough natural speed to take up a very good position and make his own luck.
Paul, Merry-Go Win, up in class, lightweight. Does he get his chance on Wednesday night?
Yeah, I think so. He's been an extremely consistent horse, since he first started racing here. I think he'll handle class three for sure, and we've got a nice gate, so, everything's lined up for him. I think he should be pretty competitive.
Where he was drawn last time out, he was stuck on the inside for a brief moment. Did that cost him the race, did you feel?
Zach said he's a bit, I think he might have cost himself. He was a bit reluctant to take the gap, although it was sort of a reasonable gap. Put that down to inexperience, but I don't know. The other horse sort of won on its merits, I think.
So would you like to see him from gate three, perhaps in a bit more clear galloping room?
Well, from gate three, he's either going to trail or be one pair further back, but just see how the race unfolds. But he's certainly got the barrier and he's got his chance to do his best.
He looks like a horse, too, that's got a good turn of foot.
Well, I think he showed that a couple of starts back when he drew 12, turned for home last, and really, really did stretch out. So, he can ride him either way, I think.
And is he a horse that you'd like to see get over a bit more ground in the future?
Oh, certainly. 1650 around the valley is really going to suit him a little bit later on. But I think he's shown a little bit more speed this year than what he did last year. That's probably just due to a bit more experience. But he's certainly got the pedigree to run 1650.
Simply Brilliant, he's a horse by Frankel, having his first run. What's your experience been like with him, Nash?
Well, his trial was great. He's pretty professional. He's had that bit of race experience, obviously. And, he's got to go to Happy Valley, which can be a bit tricky at times. But he feels, he's a sort of little compact, speedy type who should, from a nice draw, be able to sort of capitalise on that and put himself in the right spot and be competitive too.